First of all, humble salutations and pranams to Maharishi Dayanand Saraswati, without whom the re-establishment of Vedic Dharma in this world would have been impossible. And my humble pranams and salutations to my Acharyaji Swami Ram Swarupji Yogacharya, one of the most profound Vedic scholars, one of the most profound Vedic philosophers, Ashtanga Yogi, tapasvi this world has ever seen until date. My pranams to all of you, my pranams to those people who are seeing this live in Facebook and probably will see in future as well. And I specially thank to Arnab to consider me as eligible to give a speech on Vedas. Then Arnab made a poster about me as a speaker profile. He had mentioned a beautiful word as Vedic content creator and preacher. So I remembered a Ved mantra beautifully translated by Maharishi Dayanand Saraswati. The Ved mantra is from Yajurveda 32nd chapter 9th mantra. The mantra says, Om Pratat Ochedam Vritam Nu Vidvan Gandharvo Dama Vibritam Guha Sat Trini Padani Nihita Guha Saya Yastani Vedasa Pituhu Pita Asat. The meaning of this mantra is extremely, I would say, beautifully described by Maharishi. Maharishi says, Vidvan Gandharvaha Nu Pravochat. Only a Vidvan means a Vedic scholar. Gandharvaha means one who is upholder of Vedas, one who has realized the Almighty God in Samadhi, one who has realized the Vedas in Samadhi. Only he, Nu Pravochat, only verily, he is the only person who can teach, who can do pravachan to the public and establish the Vedic Dharma to the public. Nobody else has this authority or capability as per Ved mantra here. And because, why? Because the mantra says, Tat Sat Amritam. Because that person has realized the Sat Amritam, the eternal, immortal, almighty God. And Dama Guha Vibritam. And that Almighty God is the abode of the emancipated or enlightened souls. And then Guha Vibritam, that Almighty God is realized by that yogi in Samadhi inside in his heart. And Saha Yaha Veda Tani Trini Padani. Only he has or he knows Trini Padani, the three spheres of dispensation, the creation of the universe, the sustenance of the universe and the destruction of the universe, how it happens, that yogi has seen in Samadhi, Nihita Guhayam. That's why the mantra says that such a person, either male or female, such a person is Pituhu Pita Asat, is surely to be respected by all the elderly persons of this universe. There is That is the person, that is the yogi, that is the acharya whom we have to respect, and he is the only person who can give us Vedic preach, Vedic pravachan. Nobody else is authorized to do Vedic preach and pravachan. So, anyway, I don't know if you have put me as a preacher, but I would like to clarify, I am not a preacher, I am a Vedic student, I am a Vedic follower. I am learning Vedas for the last 18 years under the guidance of my Acharyaji, under the lotus feet of my Acharyaji, Swami Ram Swarupji Yogacharya. So the mantra very clearly speaks about the greatness of Rishi Muni Yogis who realizes the Vedas in Samadhi. So this brings me to the most important definition of the Vedas. The definition of Vedas is not that what we see in the book. What we read in the book is not Vedas. What we read as Rig Veda, Yajur Veda, as printed book is Sahitas. Vedas are undesired knowledge of Almighty God that emanates out of the mouth of a yogi who has realized Almighty God in Samadhi. So Vedas are always eternal because it emanates from Almighty God inside the yogi, from who is manifested inside the yogi. So that is why we say that when Maharishi Dayanand Saraswati speaks in a pravachan, that is called as Vedas, because he was speaking, he has realized Atma. Inside him, the Almighty God is speaking the knowledge through the mouth of Maharishi Dayanand Saraswati. That is the real definition of Vedas. The book what we read, that is not Vedas at all. That is Sanhita. What I am speaking now to you is not Vedas. The mantra I spoke is Yajurveda, 32nd chapter, 9th mantra. It's a Sanhita. It is a knowledge which I have read from Maharishi Dhananjaya Saraswati or from my Acharya, etc., etc. So this has to be clearly understood. So the most important message to all of the public who may probably see this video is, they have to fully-fledged search an Acharya who has attained Samadhi. And in this world, to my knowledge, only very, very few people are there who has realized Almighty God, who has realized Vedas in Samadhi. So we have to really search such a person and then go to his lotus feet and serve him and then learn and listen Vedas, because Almighty God says in the Vedas, Iti Sushruna Dhiranam Yenaha Tadavich Chakshure, in the 14th chapter. Dhiranam means one who has attained Samadhi. After the Dhyana, in Ashtanga Yoga, after Dhyana it is Samadhi. So one who has attained Samadhi, from that person you listen the Vedas, from that person you listen about Sambhuti and Asambhuti. From that person you listen Vidya and Avidya, because he is Dhir Purush, he is Samadhisthi Yogi. The next important thing what I would like to quickly clarify or address is, most of us, many of our Arya Samadhi's brothers and sisters, we are in the propagation, we are propagating Vedas, we are doing like this kind of conference, really good, very, very good. We are trying to promote Vedic knowledge to the common people. We are following the instruction of Almighty God, Trinvantam Vishnum Aryam. That is very good. But one thing what we are missing is, we cannot propagate Vedas if we are not following it ourselves. Many of our friends, my friends, many of my close friends are having surname Arya. When I ask them, do you do everyday Agnihotra? He says, no. Do you do every day name jap of Almighty God? No. Do you do every day Gayatri Mantra jap, morning and evening, as prescribed by Dhyanam Saraswati in the Satyata Pradash? No. Then are we not insulting Almighty God by putting a word Arya as a surname? Yes, because God says, Trinuvantam Vishwam Aryam. You have to make the whole world noble, but when you can make the whole world noble if you are noble. And the definition of the noble person, the first definition is, you have to worship Almighty God, who is defined as Almighty God, by Almighty God in the Vedas only. So this is the most important message all of us have to learn. If we are not doing everyday Agnihotra, then if I am not doing Agnihotra, I cannot spread the knowledge of Vedas. That will not work. My word will not have any effect on the people who is listening. This is number one. And number two, one more thing which I am seeing on my closest friends, including myself, I have this habit that we create videos against other religions, Islam, Christianity, Jainism, Buddhism, etc., etc. We can do that. We are copying verses from Maharishi's book. We are making videos. That is okay. But please understand, Maharishi Dhananjaya Saraswati, what he did, he wrote Satyartha Prakash 10 chapters about Dharma. 11th to 14th chapter he spoke about against Hinduism, bad practices, Christianity, Islam, Jainism, Buddhism, etc., etc., etc. But 10 chapters he spoke about how to live a life, how to be grihasthi, how to be a brahmachari, how the universe creation happens, who is Almighty God, what to eat, what not to eat, all these things in the Sanatan Dharma, Maharishi spent 10 chapters. So after crossing the 10th chapter, he starts speaking about other religions, and a person like Maharishi can do that, but a person like us, we cannot do that. We do not have that caliber. We are not realized Jivatma to say that you are wrong. First of all, we should correct ourselves. This is the most important second message I want to give. The first message is, we have to search an Acharya. The second message is, we have to be noble ourselves before telling that, hey, you are wrong. Your Quran has this mistake. Your Bible has this mistake. Yes. All the man-made book will have mistakes. Every man-made book will have mistakes. Atharvaveda mantra says very clearly that do not read books written by human beings. Always listen to Vedas from an Acharya and read the books written by Rishi Munis. So naturally, every book written by human being will have mistakes. But before pinpointing others' mistake, let us correct our mistake. Are we Aryas? Are we really following the principle of Maharishi Dayanand Saraswati mentioned in the first 10 chapters? No. So let us correct ourselves before correcting others. This is the second message I want to give. And another, you know, Arnab said you can speak 10 to 15 minutes. In 15 minutes, what message I can give? I was thinking from morning. The only thing I can really say is, a Rishi, one of the Rishi, I was reading Nyaya Darshana, in that one Rishi, I forgot the name of the Rishi, he mentioned very beautiful sentence. He said, the main aim of your human life is realization of Almighty God. Do not give priority to any karma or any deed which is taking away from this main priority of the human life, because this deed which is taking away from the realization is as good as burning a forest full of sandalwood trees into ashes. Such a powerful statement by Rishi, but when we really analyze, are we doing our activities in our daily life towards the realization of Almighty God? Really, no. We are behind materialism. Even when we say that we are Vedic followers, Vedic preachers, Vedic speakers, etc., in reality, at the end of the day, when we really see, we are not behind Almighty God. We are behind some other. We are behind our satisfaction of our own ego. So this has to be more. This has to be corrected. We have to really strive to correct ourselves, and then we have to strive. Like I understood Mr. Deep, he was speaking in Bengali, but I understood he spoke about the Trividhi Dukkha. Atyanta Nivritti, Atyanta Purusharatha, says Kapil Muni in Sankhya Shastra. So the Trividhi Dukkha, natural calamities, floods, earthquake, corona, mental sickness, people are in psycho patients. So many people are in mental issues in out of country. When we come and see, I can see many people. The only way we can overcome this is by doing tapasya, is by going to the feet of an acharya who is a tapasvi, who is a yogi. Lastly, I don't know if I have spoken 15 minutes, but lastly, I would like to give a clear message that every person in this world has to have a couple of books in our house. Not only have, we have to read. Satyata Prakash for sure, Rigveda Adi Bhashya Bhavamita for sure, and Arya Abhidhinaya for sure, written by Maharishi Dayanand Saraswati. But I would like to tell all of you these two, three books which everybody must have. This is in Hindi, Patanjali Yoga Darshan by my Acharya Swami Ram Surat Yogacharya. Every sutra of Yoga Darshan has been in depth described with Ved mantras, with the real knowledge of my Acharya in life. This should be a turning point book in each one of our lives if we are serious in Vedic path. And another book I would say is Srimad Bhagavad Gita, Ek Vedic Rahasya. The only book in this whole world which speaks about Sri Krishna is not Almighty God. Whatever Sri Krishna spoke in the Gita is from the Vedas only. This knowledge is written by my Acharya in this book, Srimad Bhagavad Gita, Ek Vedic Rahasya. Every shloka of Sri Krishna, my Acharya has given the reference of Ved Mantra. Based on this knowledge of Ved Mantra, Sri Krishna spoke this shloka. Because some of the Arya Samajis, we believe that there are only 70 shlokas in original Gita. It is not 700 shlokas. No. All the shlokas are true, but when we understand it from the sense of the Vedas, and only book in this world is the book written by my Acharya, I am very proud to say that. Please go through one part. There are four parts in that. If you really have some sense to understand the Vedic philosophy, you have to read part one of Bhagavad Gita written by my Acharya. You can order from vedmandir.com. And lastly, my Acharya always says a beautiful message. Life without Vedas is as good as taking our own dead body in our shoulders. So a life without Vedas is totally waste. And the Vedas means that which is emanating from an Acharya who is alive. So all of us has to be very serious. If we have to do Ved Prachar, we have to find an Acharya and then we start Ved Prachar. That will be the best way to proceed. Thank you so much. Namaste. Om. Thank you, Arnab.